The Social Inclusion Policy Fellowship is an idea that is born out of how to make the most impact in the shortest period of time in areas and issues that affects Muslims, Arabs, and communities of color in a broader sense.
The idea was, how do we understand implicit bias on American society and American communities? But the starting point for us was specifically Islamophobia. How Islamophobia mushroomed in American society and it became acceptable to dehumanize Muslims.
I thought that we had been making progress in terms of reducing racism and hatred. This program really showed me that it's more rampant than I ever knew.
I've learned more clearly that what I thought was an evil of the past is alive and well when we talk about the Muslim community and how they are being systematically targeted.
I already thought that I was like pretty like progressive and like kind of knew how to change the world. However, I realized that there are many ways we can go about making change.
I didn't realize there were so many parallels between my lived experiences and other groups. And so I feel like sometimes we just focus on life in our own little bubble and we think about our things that we're going through and not knowing or not realizing that there are other groups that go through the same types of things.
As a Muslim that's been in the fellowship, it's been really refreshing to see so many non-Muslims so eager to change the narrative as well. And that kind of has sparked more hope in me doing my own work and my day-to-day, because it does oftentimes feel like you're alone.
There are a lot of people who care about Islamophobia who aren't Muslim. A lot of people care about undocumented immigrants who aren't undocumented. And it really shows like we care about humanity, we care about people, and not just like our select identity groups, you know?
The challenges with Islamophobia is, you know, part of the zeitgeist of what's happening right now. Obviously, there's been a lot of discussion around equity, and I feel that we don't have the language and a lot of, you know, governmental spaces and even community spaces as to how equity is defined.
Being around people with different backgrounds, different educational paths, has helped me kind of seeing concretely where policies need some attention.
The fellowship has been really powerful in terms of the learning that I've done with my cohort peers, learning from experts and from practitioners, deconstructing some of these things that have just become norms.
I'm very used to thinking things in just a policy lens. And I think what the fellowship has forced me to do is think about things psychologically, thinking about things from the litigating side, right? Thinking about things from all of these various perspectives.
One of my favorite memories of the fellowship was learning with my cohort about code words and dog whistles around Islamophobia and sort of the rapid learning that took place from someone who had no basis or foundation in the Muslim experience to within a week understand how framing and shaping of Islam is often weaponized against the Muslim community.
I was very surprised to see us all bonding the way we did, like immediately, how connected we all are. There's not many spaces that we can just be vulnerable and transparent and just have these really critical conversations. And the feeling that I have in this space is something that I don't think will ever be recreated.
I didn't realize that some of our policies that we've adopted on a local level were disenfranchising members of our population. And I've been able to think about that, and I'm going to go back home and I'm going to change those policies, and I'm going to make sure I amplify the conversation and be politically brave whenever there's situations where people are being treated poorly.